If you are a React developer, there's no doubt you've heard about React 18. Now, while there's still a lot more to come, I thought you might want to see what are its top new features. The first one is automatic batching. Long story short, batching in React is whenever multiple state updates are combined into a single re-render. In this example, the component would only be rendered once after handleClick is called, although we might think setCount and setClicked would trigger two re-renders. Now, while this works well at the moment, if you're calling multiple state updates in a different context, such as a promise, a callback, or a timeout, React won't batch these two updates into one, and you get two re-renders when only one would have been needed. With React 18, all these use cases will now be covered, and state updates will be batched automatically no matter what's the context. This might remind you of unstable batched updates that was doing exactly this. Well, now, React will do it for you by default. Also, if you happen not to want these updates to be batched, you'll need to use flush sync that will re-render your component every time it's done running the function you're passing it to. So with the following, your component would render twice instead of just one time. Moving on to transitions, a really big new feature, which allows you to tell React which updates are urgent and which are not. A good example of that is a search input that should filter out a list of elements. So if you're updating a search input, you'd want its value to change as we type, although the search results might appear in a second phase when we're done typing. This is where we could mark the input value change as an urgent update and the elements filtering as secondary, also called now a transition. Transitions can be interrupted by urgent updates, and previous transitions that are no longer relevant will be dismissed. This allows the user interface to only show its most up-to-date state and skip secondary updates, transitions, that might be slower to compute and sometimes return intermediate states that are irrelevant. As you can see here, we're marking the input value change as urgent and run our secondary update inside a transition, as it might trigger slow computations and could freeze or slow down the whole user experience as we type. Start transition is great for any update you want to move to the background, such as slow and complex rendering tasks, or when updates rely on fetching data that might take time due to a slow network. If you have a React application, you might know that if you're not using server-side rendering, aka SSR, your website always appears blank when you run it for the first time. That is because the browser needs to fetch and read your JavaScript, which takes some time before your components load and the page becomes interactive. With SSR, however, the user sees how your app looks directly, but without all the interactions while the JavaScript is being loaded. The way it works is by rendering all the components on the server first, then sending the result as HTML to the browser. After that, the JavaScript is loaded as usual, and HTML magically becomes interactive by what is called hydration. This turns your static HTML elements into your dynamic React components as you know them. The main problem with this approach is that as long as this JavaScript hasn't been fetched, loaded, and your HTML hydrated, your page won't be interactive. To solve this waterfall issue, React 18 now offers two new features for SSR: streaming HTML and selective hydration. Put simply, streaming HTML means that the server can send pieces of your components as they get rendered. This works by using suspense, where you'd say which parts of your application will take longer to load and which ones should be rendered directly. If you think of an article with comments, where the article is the critical part of the page, you could say load the article, but don't wait for the comments to be ready to send HTML to the browser. You could show a spinner instead using suspense, and once the comments are ready, React will send new bits of HTML that will replace the spinner in place. Now, the second new feature, selective hydration, is quite a game changer. Where before you'd have to wait for every component to be rendered to begin hydration, leading to cut splitting problems, components now wrapped with suspense won't block hydration anymore. In other words, if we go back to our article page, the comments that we wrap with suspense won't block the article and other components to be hydrated. Every ready component will start hydrating, and the comments will too, once the browser gets both its content and JavaScript code. The last crazy thing about selective hydration is that if you happen to interact with one of the components before it's been fully hydrated, meaning you click somewhere, for example, React will prioritize this component's hydration. This ensures that the most critical interactions are to be repeated as soon as we can hydrate the related component, making sure it's hydrated before the others. All right, that's all for today. You can find great explanations of all these new features on the official repository, which is linked in the description. Remember to subscribe if you don't want to miss more videos like this one. Thanks for watching and see you next time.